everyone. I am Brooke Anderson from the TV show The Insider. And not only am I an entertainment journalist, but I am a huge Yanni fan. And so I am a very, very lucky girl today because I am here with this global phenom, this living legend, multi-talented, multi-platinum, multi-Grammy nominated artist, composer, performer, Yanni. And boy, do we have a special treat for everybody watching this live webcast, Yanni. Not only are we going to give you a private, behind-the-scenes, inside look at how Yanni prepares for his concerts, his performances, but at the end of this webcast, Yanni is going to perform his very first ever live performance for the web, and it is going to be the song Voyage from his latest album, Truth of Touch. Thanks for having me, Yanni.
It's my pleasure. Thank you for the introduction. That's like a lot of nice things
to hear. I am honored to be here. And I also want to say we are going to be taking your questions live, so get them in. What do you want to know about Yanni or about how Yanni prepares for his big shows? And you can submit those questions here at Ustream or on his Facebook page, Twitter, or by email at ask@yanni.com. And I have to tell you, Yanni, I was perusing your Facebook page earlier today, and there were so many posts. You have hundreds of thousands of fans via social media. But one post really, really struck me. Debbie wrote, "Next to God, your music is what I choose to call my higher power."
Wow.
Are you ever overwhelmed by the deep impact that you make with your music?
Yes, absolutely. And I had no idea that you could reach that far. When I was a kid and I was playing with the music and I was beginning with the idea of an instrumental music being able to be a language to talk to people with, you know, I never imagined it would reach that deep and help people through their pain or going through chemotherapy or just elevate them, make them feel good spiritually, make them strong, all that stuff. Just it's amazing to me.
Your music is very impactful. What inspires your music? What inspires your creativity?
Life. I just live. Yeah. You gotta live, you know. And that is every artist, you know. If you have to tell the truth with your art, and you have to live. You have to live. You can't really lie. You can't make up stuff.
People can see through that.
Of course.
It's transparent if you're pretending.
Yes, yes.
But you really love it.
It is, well, I've said it before, my fans know it. It's like the creative moments are just so elating. It's just addicting, very addicting.
You have said that to make things happen, you have to have faith and you have to have passion. Tell me about that.
Well, faith is obviously, you got to believe in yourself. I mean, it's very obvious. Passion is the fuel. Passion is everything. If you're not passionate, if you're not in love with what you're doing, you will never find the strength required to reach levels, really high levels. Just like an athlete, just like any a writer or a painter or anyone who wants to become at the top of their game, you have to give a lot of yourself to it. And without passion, you're never going to make it through. You're going to quit in a week or two. You're going to slack off, you're gonna slip by.
You won't have the longevity without the passion.
Yes.
And you've been at this for what, 25, 30 years?
Or so, yeah.
You look amazing, by the way.
Thank you.
You look incredible. Well, let me ask you this. You have really embraced social media and reaching out and connecting with your fans. Facebook, Twitter, like I said, email, this webcast, this live performance that you're going to do
this
on the web. Why is it so important for you to really be on the cutting edge of this social media and of the technologies that are available now?
I love the feedback that I can get from the fans. It's so great, you know, people read me, we do five cities a week right now, our schedule is grueling. And it's so cool that you can, just when you're the most tired and you don't know if you can get up the next day and do it again, you start reading people and what you've did for them the night before. And it's just, I mean, it touches my heart.
Keeps you going, the fuel, like you say. Well, I have a question for you, Yanni. You have performed in some of the most unbelievable venues, the Taj Mahal in mm-hmm. India, the Forbidden City in China. What is the most memorable place you have ever performed?
They all are, you know. I love the Acropolis because I was playing in front of a home audience. Mm. But these monuments belong to the planet. The Taj Mahal. How could you forget playing at the Taj Mahal? Right. Full moon.
Oh, wow.
And the Forbidden City, too. Back in 97, you have to remember, it was in 97 when we were in China. It was all, you know, but then what makes a concert is also the audience. Mm-hmm. You know, playing in Rio de Janeiro, you know. Rio de Janeiro is probably more correctly pronounced. You know, just the audiences make you never forget places because of the way they react, respond to you, and you feel the love. They give you back so much passion and so much love. And it's hard to say, you know, I like this mm-hmm. concert more than the other or than the other. Mm-hmm. You know,
I'm sure you're going to have a really electric audience here tonight. We're backstage in a dressing room at the Nokia Theater in downtown Los Angeles. It's a fantastic, fantastic venue.
It is.
And I do, Yanni, want to get to a few questions submitted by some of your fans right now. Here's Jean. She's from here in the United States. And she wants to know what you eat before your performances. What's your energy food? Before you hit the stage, because it takes a lot of energy to get up there and do what you do.
You're not going to believe this. Nothing.
Nothing.
I get up in the morning usually and I eat very little and I work out. And then I do not touch food until well after midnight or so.
Oh.
And I've trained myself because of being in the studio. If I eat, I become lethargic.
Mm.
Over the years, I've learned how I can go through like 12 hours of not eating anything.
So breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
And it's small. It's not a whole lot.
Oh, okay. And then you work out daily?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I gotta say, Yanni looks pretty ripped. What do you do?
I'm not fanatic about it. I just do for health reasons. It's just to feel energetic, to be able to be on stage and not hurt myself. You know, you can hurt your knees, you can hurt, you're jumping around, you're doing things. It's just being fit is a good thing.
Yeah, you gotta be athletic to get up there and be that active.
Yes, when I was a kid, I was a swimmer, so I've been through a lot of. I understand the pain of the training. I've been through it, so I can tolerate that kind of pain easily.
You're dedicated. You're committed. Okay, here's what Louise, also an American here in the United States, wants to know. Are you going to be giving out kisses every concert from now on? Everyone will want one now, Yanni, especially me. This is Louise. She says that she will be at the Vegas concert. Hint, hint.
There's good. You know, it was fun. I had fun with that. I must admit, there was a lot of. I didn't expect it either. But there's a magic phrase that has to be used.
Oh.
To get me to do it. That's a code.
What's the code?
I'm not going to give
you
the code.
Can you let us in on it?
No, they're going to have to figure it out.
So it's a spontaneous decision by you when you're up there performing if you want to do that.
That's right.
All right. So the women are just swooning in the crowd.
Well, it's fun. I mean, it's just, you know, it touches. It's the same stuff. You know, they just show you their love and appreciation.
Yeah.
You know, it's not. I love it. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, what is most gratifying for you, Yanni, about your work? Is it the creative process, the actual music, or your fans and their reaction, their deep appreciation and admiration?
It's all of it, and it depends on the time. When I'm in the studio writing, I do not think of the fans. I think about how to tell the truth, and I give myself completely to what I want to talk about. When I'm on the road and I'm playing in front of the fans are everything. And many years ago when I went through some very difficult times, the fans pretty much turned me around. It was one of those. I've said the story before, we don't have to go through it right now. So the fans are extremely important in the reason I'm here 30 years later doing it.
So the fans aren't just fans, but they're a family to you in a way.
They are. I have a connection with them, and you can see it at the concerts. You can feel it at the concerts. You know, it's they give me back as much as I give them, if not more. Mm-hmm. And it's as healing to me. They tell me I heal them, but they heal me.
How so?
Well, just because of their appreciation. And again, I was trying to avoid having to tell the whole story, but it was, I went through a pretty severe depression a few years ago. And I went home to Greece and I stayed there and I hadn't touched the piano for a whole year.
Wow.
I just decided I wasn't gonna do music anymore. And my sister was very clever. She sent me a stack of letters from the fans, and I had it there for months and I wouldn't look at it. And one day I started reading, and it just moved me to tears that I forgot who I was and what I had done for these people. And it reminded me that my life has meaning. Mm. I'm not just doing music by myself in a vacuum. Mm-hmm. I'm affecting people. So that was the beginning of the turnaround for me.
Mm-hmm. That is really, really touching. And I think we have a fan question coming in right now. Thank you very much. All right, this is from Fernando via Facebook. Mm-hmm. Do you ever get nervous before a concert, Yanni?
Always.
Always, yeah. Really?
Well,
opening
night is the worst, but a little bit. The adrenaline comes in, but it's a good nervous. It's not a scared nervous. It's a, okay, I'm ready, let's go, I'm excited. Mm-hmm. You know, I want to do this.
Exhilaration.
Yes, and once you get in front of 10,000 people, it's a feeling that very difficult to explain to somebody. You mm-hmm. have to, I don't care if you're tired, if you're sick, if you have a headache, it all goes away.
Probably like no other feeling in the world that you've had.
Yeah, it's up there.
Yeah. All right. The next question we have is Shirley from here in the USA. I loved this concert and I have so many great memories from it. Can you share with us one or two of your memorable events from this tour so far?
The kissing part.
Shirley's gonna like that, Yanni.
there was a lot of them. I don't wanna isolate audiences. You know, every audience is different, and we end up in the same place by the end of the concert. I feel this particular tour that I'm more connected with the fans mm-hmm. during the concert. It's more close, it's more intimate. Mm-hmm. And I love that part. I love that I can hear them talk. And sometimes we do a question and answer period. And, mm-hmm. and you know, it's been fun everywhere we've been.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, I cannot wait to see your performance of Voyage. So why don't we now make our way to the stage. So everyone stay where you are and keep submitting those questions by ask@yanni.com, Ustream, his Facebook page, Twitter. Keep submitting those questions and we'll get some more in. But right now, we're gonna make our way to the stage.
Can I say happy Mother's Day, everybody?
Oh, very good. Yes, it is Mother's Day. So happy Mother's Day to all of you mothers celebrating in part by participating in this webcast with us.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Come on this way.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so we've made our way from backstage, from the dressing room, here to the side of the stage.
Successfully.
And we, successfully, we made it, we ran. And we are here at what's called Monitor World,
yes.
Is that right? And
yes.
Who do we have here? What is this?
This is where, actually, this is Paul Soto, our monitor engineer.
Hi, Paul.
And I usually come in every day and I say, you have a customer. And he says, already?
Already?
There you go, that's your line. He gives me these earpieces and this here little box.
Mm-hmm.
These earpieces are critical. Mm-hmm. What he does back here, this is a matrix, and a very complicated matrix at that. Paul is one of the best engineers in the world at doing this. These earpieces block the sound of big halls like 10,000 PC arenas and echoes and clean up the sound. And through these, all these musicians can hear each other in any blend they choose. So it's a very complex matrix.
So each person customizes what they want to hear with their earpieces. So yours is very different from, say, your violinist or your cello player.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So, I mean, you get so intricate that you can just say, I just want to hear the snare drum a little louder.
Mm-hmm.
Or I want to hear a single violin or cello. Or everybody gets to hear everybody else. So you can imagine the complexity of what this man is doing.
It is very complicated. How long does it take to get the sound and get everyone's mix just right before you hit the stage for a live performance?
Once you do it during rehearsals, it's pretty much well set.
Okay.
Then we don't change too much from day to day.
Okay.
But it could take a couple of weeks to get all the stuff lined up and working.
Okay, and this is crucial for every live
absolutely.
Show. And who's responsible for making sure this gets to the stage?
Right there.
Right here. Doesn't look nervous, no pressure.
I'm going to give it to you.
Very nice to meet you. Thank you so much. All right, why don't we go over and meet the orchestra?
Let's see some of the stuff.
Hey.
And they're all here. That's Victor.
Hi, Victor.
Hello.
From Paraguay. This is Sarah.
Hello.
Playing the cello. And this is Sasha.
Hello, Sasha.
Alexander Zurov, and check out this
the way the microphone.
Look how little it is.
Mm-hmm. So how is the cello? I'm sure it has to be in a certain place. It's very exact. Right?
Exactly within a it's also trade secret, so we don't want to say a whole lot. But and then it gets this particular microphone. You'll hear it tonight during the performance. It has a great noise rejection, but it goes through a lot of electronics. And it does justice to this instrument. It's very difficult to take an acoustic instrument and run it through a whole PA and amplify it to 120 decibels. It's a whole different animal.
I'm sure.
And to make it sound pleasant, it's taken us 20 years to come up with these little techniques.
To perfect it just how it needs to be.
And it's happening. Like, Sam, where's your band? This is Sam Volgervinian from Armenia. And he's playing a very small cello.
Small cello.
I happen to think he's probably the best violinist in the world.
Wow.
And he's got a similar situation going, but different electronics and different, And Sasha is from Moscow.
Wow.
And we're getting ready to go over there and do a concert tour of Eastern Europe, and he's going to be teaching me Russian.
Oh, really? Oh, that's fair. How many languages do you speak?
Not a lot, but every country that I go to, I learn,
try to learn
a little
the
bit.
Language.
Yeah.
Okay.
I speak Greek fluently, though.
I'm sure.
And English, I get, and a little bit of French.
Well, you know, you're from Greece, but you're an American.
Yeah.
So would you say you are Greek or American or both?
First of all, I would say I'm a human being.
Yeah.
Then Greek, American, Chinese, Indian, whatever.
Yeah.
It's just. And I learned that from the ancient Greeks. We're citizens of the world.
That's right. That's a very nice way to put it. Okay.
That's the piano. Everybody's seeing the piano. It has microphones inside. It gets amplified. It's not as interesting to discuss. But let me
show you. Everything's fascinating to me, Yanni. Believe
me. Show you the keyboards.
The keyboards. Let's look at those.
This is a matrix. You see six keyboards, but really there's more than six.
Mm-hmm.
There's probably 20 in here.
Explain that. I see six, but there are 20 or more.
Yes, there's a rack back here. There are virtual keyboards too.
Okay.
And these instruments talk to each other. Mm-hmm. So just because I touch one keyboard, it doesn't mean you're only hearing this keyboard.
Okay.
I can have, for example, like up here I have horns. Like, and I mean, this instrument is playing another three or four. So okay. You're hearing trombones, French horns, and of course, the whole horn
That's
section,
right.
too.
The entire orchestra back here.
So you're
wow.
getting a blend of mm-hmm. electronics and
mm-hmm.
acoustics.
Mm-hmm.
Like this particular keyboard right now is probably going to play six different instruments simultaneously. You get this one.
Beautiful.
And you get that big sound.
Gorgeous.
One push of a button. And all the keyboards change sounds. Everything
okay,
becomes
so you're constantly.
I have piano here.
Beautiful.
If you are, it's this constantly switching sounds. For
you're constantly switching to vary from song to song. What you need.
Here's some plucked violins. And you have strings. Some of the fans they recognize the song. I know.
They are. Yeah.
So it's a lot of fun.
I bet it is.
Put it back on 12.
And the fans, I'm sure, are having a lot of fun getting this behind-the-scenes access, yeah. this private tour. And Yanni, I have to ask you, it's so nice of you to introduce us to these talented performers behind you and these artists. And I understand your drummer, that you have worked with him for, what, 30 years?
Yes.
All the hello back there. All the way back to your rock and roll band days, back when you wore leather pants and no shirt.
I never wore leather pants, and I know they're going to put up. What are you laughing? Now they're going to put up the picture with me, the
sure
leather pants.
I'm sure we can dig up a picture somewhere,
I'm
Yanni.
Sure you can.
All right, we're getting another question in, I believe, from one of the fans. And here we go. Thank you so much. All right, this is from Brazil via Twitter. Okay, 1 minute before you get on stage, what do you think of and how do you feel? 60 seconds before.
I close my eyes. I won't show you exactly what I do, but it's a complete focus and I see everything going well. There are so many different things that can go wrong during one of these concerts because it's the most complicated show there is out there right now.
Mm-hmm.
So I just have a way of just accepting that no matter what happens, we'll be able to deal with it. I take nothing for granted when you're live. Mm-hmm. Live is very exposed.
Very, like we are right now.
Yes.
Very unpredictable.
Yeah.
So a form of meditation in a way.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, when I was watching a sound check earlier, Yanni, I can tell you are a perfectionist, as am I, as are so many. But I understand that sensibility. And you told everyone, you know, all right, let's do this song, but I'm not going to know when to stop. So you've got to tell me when to stop.
Mm-hmm.
But that's, in a sense, what drives you, isn't it?
Yeah, it's I tend to be hands-on.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe too much sometimes, but, you know, I it's a choreography.
Mm-hmm.
In order to hear something and see something and make sure it all blends well, it's a choreography. The light has to be on, the camera has to be in the right place, you got to be in the right place, the sound has to be correct. There's a million different things that have to happen. Plus, you have to play well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All of that together, if you can do it really well, then you have magic.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it is so magical. Your music is so mesmerizing. It's so many things all at once. It's energizing. It's romantic. It's gorgeous. I think we've got time for one more live question from the fans. This is Cindy via Twitter. What is the most unexpected incident you have had to deal with on stage during a concert? And that goes to what we were just talking about, how it is so unpredictable.
It could be anything from funny stuff to dangerous stuff.
Oh, dangerous?
Well, dangerous meaning like things...
falling or blowing up?
Or power. I walked out, I remember in Denver many years ago, and somebody hit a power pole and the power went out just as you walk on stage and you start and the whole sound goes out.
Oh,
no. It happens, you know. It's... there is no, I close my eyes. I pray.
Just pray everything goes well.
Yes.
Well, I have a question for you. You have all of this equipment, and you are going from city to city, show to show. How do you logistically make sure it all gets to from point A to point B and everything works out smoothly in that regard? Because you take the same keyboards, the same piano with you all around the world, yes?
Yes. We have the most amazing crew in the world. That's where it is, and it is like a military. It's mm-hmm. You'll see how quickly they put the show up and take it down. I have some of the best in the world. Mm-hmm. People that do the sound, mixing, the monitor engineers, the people who do the lights, they're just top of the line. Mm-hmm. The same as the musicians. And in fact, we see the musicians and the crew as one. Mm-hmm. There is no, they are as good at what they do as we are at what we do. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then it all works well.
Oh, it certainly does. Okay, we've got time for another live question, I'm told. This is Sanda from Twitter. You are very candid on stage, Yanni. Do you get annoyed at times by your fans showering their declarations of love for you? Do you ever get annoyed?
No, I never get annoyed at fans. Why would you get annoyed? They you know, my job is to entertain them and uplift them, and they have every right to expect everything from me, and I expect nothing from them. Mm-hmm. Whatever they give me is a gift. Mm-hmm. I don't have a problem with that. It's just,
yeah, it doesn't seem like you take any of your success for granted.
No. Why? That would be foolish, mm-hmm. I think. Mm-hmm. There's no guarantees. And we know, especially if you're an entertainer, mm-hmm. and especially if you're like I am, who I'm stubborn enough to only want to do the music I like to do, and I don't really care what's in today or last year, mm-hmm. and what's selling, what's not selling. I've been able to write music the way I believe in it, the way it sounds good to me, with total disregard for my career. Mm-hmm. And yet I have all these fans around the world that want to hear what I have to say.
Have embraced it, yeah.
It's like, thank you. It's awesome.
And you say you're stubborn?
Yes.
Okay, let's get another question in from the fans. This is Arturo. This is also via Twitter. Boy, getting a lot via Twitter. Okay, when I listen to music, especially instrumental, I see colors in my mind, sometimes even pictures. Mm-hmm. Does this ever happen to you?
Yes, you can. I've heard people writing books to my music. I've gotten letters of people who can paint listening to my music.
Oh.
And they were not able, or they had a mental block. They felt they had a mental block. They use my music to open their mind. Mm-hmm. I begin with the emotion. Mm-hmm. I feel something, and it's usually very powerful, and it moves me into choosing sounds and rhythms, and I usually write in my mind. Mm-hmm. I don't have to play.
Okay.
I just kind of close my eyes and feel. When you feel the emotion, then it's easy to choose the sound, the rhythm, mm-hmm. the speed, mm-hmm. you know, how you're going to go in and out, you know. It's
immerse yourself. Feel mm-hmm. it. I have a question. All the aspiring artists, instrumentalists, performers out there who really look up to you and would love to follow in your footsteps in some way, what advice would you have for them?
So again, we were talking about it. Love what you do. It's passion. You have to love it. And dedication. You got to have faith in yourself, of mm-hmm. course. A lot of times we think, who do I think I am that I'm going to go write some instrumental music and the whole world will care? And that thought alone will stop you. Mm. So it's not like I didn't have this thought. I just didn't spend a lot of time in it. Mm-hmm. And just work at your craft. You got to stay with your craft. There's no, if you ask me, how did I get here? I have no idea. I just do it. I'm on a one-track mind. I am stubborn, yes. And I work. I sit down and I work.
You're committed. You're dedicated to your craft. Okay, one more live question, I'm told. Thank you very much. This is Saif from Egypt. I hope I pronounced your name correctly. Sorry if I did not. Are you going to compose a song for Egypt? You have a lot of fans here, and we love you. All caps here, love you.
Right.
Yes.
I know that, and I'm going to do one better. I'm hoping to go play there. I want to play at the Tahrir Square. And a lot of Egyptian people have been asking me to go there and play. Mm-hmm. We hope to make that happen sometime. And yes, You know, I don't know about writing a specific song, but probably I will mm-hmm. when we do that concert.
Mm-hmm. Oh, can't wait for that. Okay, now it is time for you to get ready.
Yes.
Just, you've got a couple of minutes. I'm going to go into the audience, but coming up, stay right where you are. We are going to hear Yanni's first ever live performance on the web. It is Voyage. So keep it right here. Stay here. All right. Thanks, Yanni.
Okay. Okay, I think we're just about there. It's up to you now. Somebody's gonna have to give me a cue.
And participating in this live webcast with the phenom Yanni. We really appreciate it, and thanks to you for submitting your questions. Sorry we didn't have time to get all of them in, but thank you so much. And now, the moment you have been waiting for, here is Yanni in his first ever live performance on the web. Here's Voyage from his latest album, Truth of Touch.
Mm-hmm.